Today we are talking about stuff, meaning we will talk about the current situation with season 6 and the PTS specifically, as well as some other stuff that I wanted to talk about that doesn't really fit into other videos. So in a way, this will also be a little bit of an update, but let us begin with the elephant in the room. Season 6 is coming up very soon, and I was, for the most part, very much looking forward to it. I think that a lot of the changes are very interesting. There's a lot of things that I can analyze, and we have Merlin coming out, which I think is a pretty cool guard. I think he has got a very interesting, unique design that we haven't seen before. So those things should make me excited for season 6 under normal circumstances. Of course, you can already tell from what I'm saying is there is a but coming. And the but is this PTS. Now, PTS has always been a bit of an annoying experience, like trying to test the new things before they actually came out on the PTS, on the public test server, has always been a bit of a struggle. You didn't really know when it would come up, then it was sometimes a little bit unstable, and getting enough people on there is relatively hard. But it's gotten worse, and it's gotten worse and worse and worse, and we are at the point where I can no longer really just ignore and accept it. So Hyrus frequently complains, or not directly complains, but states that there aren't enough players playing the PTS to get any reliable data, because there are just fractions of the player base actually going on the servers. There have been proposed solutions for that, like extra rewards for people playing on those servers, and I think it would be reasonable. I don't think it necessarily would have to be gems, but maybe just some XP being transferred over to the normal servers, because quite often you basically lose out on favor and everything else that you would get on the normal servers. But I don't think that's even the main point. I think a lot of players want to try out the new content and they want to see what it's like. And also you have the option to try everything on PTS by buying it with gems. So I think that's enough of an incentive for many people to play. Unfortunately, the changes that we're generally seeing as of late don't encourage playing PTS at all. The first one is the most straightforward one, being that PTS was entirely removed from the standalone client, with very little notice actually. So basically out of nowhere, PTS was suddenly only available and updating on Steam, and you could only use that version for PTS, and the standalone version didn't work anymore for no reason whatsoever, with no message. And then patches later, Hyrus actually announced that it will only be on Steam from now on. Okay, should have maybe let us know earlier. And also there are issues with the Steam version, because if you're playing the standalone client and not the Steam client, then it may be the case for you, not necessarily, but it may be the case for you that the Steam PTS will not work. For me, for example, that was the case. If I have the standalone Smite client, then I will have an issue with easy anti-cheat if I try to just install the Steam PTS. And I know that there are other issues that other people have, so this is not just me. I therefore had to transfer everything over to Steam, and I just use the Smite Steam version now, which is whatever, but that is already one of those factors where I'm like, why was this not communicated? Why was this not probably thought through and adjusted accordingly so that everyone can use that? Next thing, the downtimes that we have right now. Now, downtimes with PTS are normal and understandable. I know that Hyrus often changes things on the builds and makes quick fixes with issues on PTS, which is generally obviously a good thing. And it's understandable that those are within the work times of Hyrus employees. Also very logical once again, because that's when they can actually check if the new patch went up normally and everything. What's not understandable is taking the PTS down every single evening for EU. And that is what has been happening. We have not had a single day of the current PTS where the EU players could actually play during the normal times. You could play super late at night when it was an A night, or you could play at some point in the morning, maybe if you have time to play in the morning. And that's about it. And obviously for most people, that means they cannot play PTS. And I thought, well, at least it's going to be better on the weekend because they're going to leave the PTS up over the weekend. Nope, they're working on the PTS on the weekend as well. And I did not have a single chance since the very first day to actually try out Merlin at all or test anything else on PTS when there are tons of changes. And you know, you tolerate that for a while, but eventually it gets pretty frustrating. And it would be nice if it ended there, but that's not all either. On top of that, there no longer seems to be any support for EU servers on PTS at all. You're purely playing on NA with their lag, which makes it especially hard to test out new gods, especially with the new gods relying more on quick ping. So for example, with King Arthur, a problem that I ran into was that swapping stances and using the abilities didn't work properly because my ping was too high, so one input was just a little bit too early or too late, and things didn't work also as they should, so obviously it makes it harder to play gods. And there was also no reason given here, we were never informed of this, it just kind of happened. And sometimes you can actually still select EU servers, but it seems to be NA servers anyways. Also, we still don't have servers for other regions, which is something that's been asked for a long time, and I really don't understand why there, for example, isn't a server for Southeast Asia or for OCE. And I don't know how exactly servers for PTS work, but as far as I understand it, they would simply have to branch out some of the servers from the main client. Maybe that's wrong, maybe it works completely differently, it's a lot more complicated, but it still doesn't make sense to take out half of your PC player base. It also doesn't make sense that consoles don't have PTS, but hey. There's also no schedule for anything regarding PTS. You don't know when they're going to take anything down, and that obviously complicates all of this even more. Now, I'm not saying that Hyrus is biased against EU players here or biased against non-Steam users or anything. My impression is rather that they've simply forgotten about those. They simply, when releasing new patches, don't really think about those parts of the player base and are like, I guess that part is not important enough, whatever. You know, let's just get this new patch out and then the people from NA can test it and the rest will test it eventually or something. It's not so much that they don't want EU to test, but it's just inconvenient for them to cater around EU, and we are the ones that end up being annoyed with it. I mean, ironically, this video will be released around NA watch time for most of you, but I hope you will still get why having half of the player base on a specific platform shut off is kind of a bad idea. And in that sense, I also want to inform you, if you want to play with me, PTS is a good chance to do so. Make sure to update your PTS right now, basically, whenever you can. And I will announce when I'm playing in customs on PTS, so we can actually test new things in your gods, both on my community tab, if you click on the bell, and on my Discord, discord.gg/DukeSloth. So if you want to be informed about when I'm playing PTS, those are the places to go. Just wanted to throw that in here for those of you who want to check out the new stuff as well, if the servers are ever up in a reasonable time. But yeah, all in all, that has really curbed my hype for Season 6 a little bit, and I really hope that Hyrus takes care of that so that everyone gets a chance to actually test the new content and give feedback for it as well. Of course, there will still be math surrounding the item changes, etc. It just feels a little bit nicer to be actually able to test them all in-game as well and feel those things put into practice and not just go by the numbers, because especially with a god like Merlin with his long windups, that can be very, very misleading. More on that soon. Outside of that, I also have some other news that I want to talk about. I'm going to be very, very busy with stuff in real life for at least the next 20 days, if not longer. And then I get a quick breather and then I have to do more stuff again. So until roughly April, I think my upload schedule may be a bit messy, and sometimes there will be videos, sometimes there won't. I will try my best to get something in, some quick content at least, to keep you guys entertained when I can, but I have to finish up some stuff for uni, I have to do tons of other stuff, and yeah, it's going to take a while and I can't purely focus on content creation like I can otherwise. And in that sense, I also want to try out some other things, especially as long as PTS really isn't given any favors in regards to Europe. I want to look at some games a little bit more, and again, after having looked at them in the past, and one of those is Sea of Thieves, which I already did in a very recent video, which you can check out here. And I also want to look at Realm Royale again, which is getting a bit of a resurgence at the moment. And I also want to look at Anthem, where I didn't want to buy the VIP beta because I was like, I'm not going to pay for this game just yet, but they will have an open beta, so you can take a look at it there. And I want to kind of get an impression of it and talk about how I feel about the game. And last but not least, for those of you who are still listening right now, I've looked through a lot of stuff regarding my channel lately, and I've noticed something compared to many, many other channels, not even my channels, just completely different channels, is that a lot of you guys seem to enjoy what I'm doing and seem to enjoy my content, and a lot of you like to comment on it as well. But compared to other channels, my like ratio is pretty bad. My dislike ratio is very low as well. It just seems that a lot of you simply don't click like or dislike at all and just go straight to the comments or just watch the video. While there's of course nothing wrong with it, I just wanted to let you know that for me, for the channel, it helps if you click the like button. And I don't want to become one of those channels that consistently has to beg in the video to click the like button. So I just wanted to quickly let at least one of you who are watching right now know this way. It would be much appreciated if you like just do that one click. It really helps the channel. Not necessarily on this video, this is just an info video in general anyways, but just, you know, for future reference. Or, you know, click the dislike button if something really bothers you. Interaction is interaction anyways. And with that, thank you guys very much for watching. I hope this was a little bit interesting, a little bit entertaining, and gave you a bit of an overview of what's happening at the moment. If you're new to the channel, feel free to smash that subscribe button. And other than that, see you for the next one tomorrow. Duke Sloth, out.